All right, it's an all CPL finals buy or sell. Remember, CPL finals this Saturday at Tim Hortons Field. Our pregame show starts at 3 p.m. Eastern. All right, guys, buy or sell. The regular season records between these two teams, specifically the Cavs, make them the favorites heading into the finals.
I'll buy. I'm torn on as far as this matchup is concerned. Part of me feels like Cavalry are clear favorites, and I think they are the best team in this league. And then another part of me looks at the head-to-head record between these two teams specifically, and maybe it's a bit closer than that. But I just think you look at so many different things, whether it's stats, whether it's, you know, the performances in the, maybe not the results always, but the performances in the games between these two teams. I think Cavalry are the favorites, and if they play to their best, they will win.
I will sell. And based on the head-to-head record between these two teams, there's not a lot between them when they get together. I think we could be in for a really tight, entertaining, but tight final.
I'm selling for the same reason. Forge 3-2-0 against Calvary during the regular season. Yeah. We're not going to talk about the Canadian championship. that doesn't suit me. Buy or sell, Borges should continue in number 10 role versus Cavs in these CPL finals.
Well, this is a pretty interesting one because the past two games against Cavalry, Borges didn't play at Spruce Meadows last time, but the two games at Tim Hortons Field, Borges has played in the middle in both of them. And so you would think that, you know, if Bobby's thinking about doing that for the finals, then, or, you know, he's going to test that out in the games leading up to the finals. And it would be kind of surprising to see him go back out to the wing. So I'm going to buy. I think he might be there, and he might be the center of this team for the finals.
Sell, because I think if he can get himself into space out on the wings, I think he can be really, really effective.
I have sell here, but I think I'm going to buy because I think part of the strategy might be trying to move Borges away from Dominic Zator, which I think could be a good move in the end for them. Right. Buy or sell, Cavs can afford to lose by one at Tim Hortons Field. Mike, I remember, a couple weeks ago, you had said that a 1-0 loss for them
would be okay,
which was absurd,
yes.
But are you buying or selling that?
I'll buy that they can afford to lose 2-1 or 3-2. 1-0, I think, is going to cause them a problem. And you know, we've seen 2-1-0 Forge wins the last two games at Tim Hortons Field. So Cavalry has to score. The away goals rule is going to be important. They are going to get Dominique Malonga back in the lineup, and that will make a big difference compared to last.
Are you still backing your 1-0?
I'm still backing. Obviously, you want away goals. Obviously.
Yeah.
But I think they could go to Spruce Meadows and win by two or more goals. Especially if the weather is funky out in Calgary for that second leg. Anything can happen.
It doesn't make goal scoring easy.
It doesn't make goal scoring easy, but I could see them. I could see them filling the net against Forge.
All right. Buy or sell. Cavs can cope without Ledgerwood in the first leg. You'll remember Nick Ledgerwood got injured at Tim Hortons Field. We see it right here on the screen. That's the total Nick Ledgerwood challenge there. It's kind of a meaningless match, but he's going to send the message anyway. And now we're wondering if he will be a part of the first leg. I think he's doing okay, so it could be interesting. But if he's not there, buy or sell, can they cope without him?
I'll buy. I think they can cope without him. I'm a big Adekubi fan, and I think he can step in, but there's no doubt that you want Ledgerwood in there. Just this kind of game, you know, when it's all on the line, he's such a leader. You see from that, he won't duck out of any challenge, and I think particularly in an away game where you're going to have to resist some pressure at some point, that's the guy you want on the field.
There's a rumor Adekubi's in your best 11.
There's a rumor.
Well, we'll see on Saturday. You buying or selling that Calgary will be okay without Ledgerwood?
Tough to say. I'm going to sell because I think, and I like Adekubi as well, but that big game experience, and we saw it at BC Place in the second leg against Vancouver Whitecaps, how critical Ledgerwood was to just being a calming, steadying influence for that team. I think if he's unable to go at Tim Hortons Field, it could be a problem for Cavalry.
I'm going to buy it. They'll be okay without him for the first leg. Let's move on. Buy or sell, Borges holds off Malonga for Golden Boot. I can tell you, some people around Forge Camp were not happy to find out that Tristan Borges had indeed not won the Golden Boot yet, because it won't be decided until after the CPL Finals. But can he hold off Malonga?
I agree with them, but I'm going to sell. I think, and I'm going to go back to a previous buy or sell, I think Borges is going to play in midfield, and I think that might make him more of a creator than a goal scorer. I can't see Dominique Malonga not scoring in this series, and when he scores one, he tends to score two. I'm going to go for Malonga.
I'll sell as well. I could see Malonga having a really big series for Cavalry. Obviously, Borges is in pole position right now, but I got a feeling that Malonga is going to really show up in this series.
I'm going to buy because Borges holds the assist tiebreaker right now, so Malonga would have to score two. So that's why I'm buying.
He always does score two. So
that's there you go. That's why you said that. Buy or sell. Kyle Becker versus Julian Boucher is the key finals battle.
Could be. I'm going to sell. I think containing Malonga might be the key battle, but these are the two best midfielders in the league, at least in terms of, you know, proper central midfielders. Different types of players. Becker is obviously more creative, more of a passer. Boucher's got that more all-round game, but yeah, it's going to be a great fight between two MVP candidates for me.
I will buy because I think Becker is such a catalyst for Forge in terms of their attack. If Cavalry can shut him down, I think the pathway to victory for Forge in this series gets really, really narrow.
I'm going to sell because I think both of those guys will show up, but I think the other guys around them, the Franos, the Janssens, however well they play could be a deciding factor in this one, whichever one comes in. All right, buy or sell, Forge's defensive absences a cause for concern. Of course, Dominic Samuel will be out through red card suspension, Awundi out through yellow card suspension. Are they in trouble?
I think so. I think a little bit. I'll buy. It depends if you believe Forge that they have a fully fit squad, except for the suspended guys. Now, obviously, we haven't seen a lot of Johnny Grant at all lately. Janssen has had injury problems in the second half of the season. So then you start to get a bit stretched, because if Janssen can't play, then Frano needs to play in midfield. And if Frano needs to play in midfield and Johnny Grant's not there, who's going to play right back without Samuel? So they need those guys to be healthy, but more importantly, they need them to be in form, and that could be difficult given the games they've
missed. The Forge guys yesterday, we were down at Tim Hortons Field doing a little bit of pre-CPL Finals content, and they assured me that everybody's healthy, Mike. Are they just playing games with me?
They might be. I do, and this is one of the reasons why I think Malonga might have a big series, is because Cavalry scored over 50 goals this season. They're a team that you need to have your best back line available, and if we know that Samuel won't be available, I could see this being a big, big issue for Forge, particularly in that first leg.
Yeah, I'm going to sell. I think it's going to make the Edgar pickup midway through the season look all that much more important. And Crutzen's been excellent. I think they'll go with that partnership in the middle of the back. I think they'll be okay. Buy or sell, Jose Escalante gets up to no good in Hamilton.
He wouldn't, would he?
Not him, surely not.
No, never.
You have to buy this, don't you?
No, I'm going to sell.
He's going to change his ways.
He's going to change his ways. I think Jose winds it in. He knows how big this game is and these two games are. And maybe he might have a word in someone's ear at some point, but I think he's going to keep it pretty low key.
Don't forget, this is the same guy who got Dominic Samuel sent off for Forge at Tim Hortons Field.
Job done. He doesn't need to do any more now. Okay.
I'll buy because, and I think back to the Canadian Championship Series between these two teams. Escalante came on in the second half of the first leg and just wreaked all kinds of havoc. Huge dust up at the end of that first leg. I think he'll be up to his old tricks.
All right, I'm going to buy it because that's him. I mean, this is like 25% of his game is like 75% is how much talent he has, and he's a great attacking winger. The other 25% is what else he brings to the dark arts.
Generous there with only 25%.
Okay, let's wrap this up with a buy or sell. Cavs are already the CPL's real champions. We only threw this in there because we've seen a few people on Twitter talk about how if you win the spring season and the fall season, how can you not be champions? That's kind of, come on.
So yeah, it's silly. Like the season structure is what it is, and so when the main goal is not to win the spring season or the full season or the overall table, Forge are going to do things in terms of their squad rotation that obviously, you know, maybe makes them drop a few points along the way. So if you like the structure or not, it is what it is. The finals are the main prize, and everyone has played towards that.
There's a traditional part of me that believes that long-term success should supersede a short playoff run, but I will sell on this one because welcome to North America and welcome to North American sport. It's what you do in the playoffs when the lights turn up bright that matters the most. The real CPL champ will be crowned on November 2nd.
The people who talked about how Calvary are already the real champions, do you think they watched every Calvary Forge matchup this season? Do you think they'll watch both CPL finals games? Yeah. Of course they will, because the entertainment value is enormous. All right, one more break here when we get back. Some early predictions for the CPL finals and our best memories from this inaugural season.